While supervising some of the projects under DRDIP in Hoima, Achan noted that ghost projects created by some leaders were discovered. She cited Kasenyi Liato Wetland Restoration Project, situated in Yakabingo Parish, Buseruka Sub-County, that has never been implemented, yet 50 million shillings under DRDIP is said to have been injected in the ghost project. She further discovered a 65 million shillings Runga solar-powered lighting project in Kapapi Sub-County that had been created under the same project but has never been implemented. All the ghost projects were created in the 2021-2022 financial year.
The implementing partners did not implement at all, and the community took it upon themselves to implement. And that is where we have raised a red flag for the district technocrats, because the district technocrats need to be on the ground to ensure that implementation of this project actually happens. So they did not do project site visits. They did not have group meetings with the IPs.
She has halted the implementation of the ghost projects and ordered the Hoima Chief Administrative Officer to recover the money injected in the ghost projects or look for other implementers to undertake them afresh.
Buseruka Secondary School, where we noted the irregular procurement, we decided to halt the procurement and ask the Chief Administrative Officer to begin a procurement process afresh. But we will be issuing a detailed report on all those 18 projects with our recommendations on what action the district needs to take in order to streamline and clean up the process.
Achan further blasted Hoima district leaders over failure to monitor and supervise the implementation of the project.
This is a great risk because the projects are ending. Now, if they have not submitted the work plans up to now, then when is the work going to actually be done? So we noted all access to energy sub-projects were not implemented at all, and to put as a risk because the project implementation is actually behind schedule.
And that one, we took immediate steps from writing to the contractors. We copied you in that letter. We wrote to the contractors who had abided that contract is no more. We are going to start a new fresh process because it was wrong with the priorities. We also recommended that we put aside the officers who are involved in that process, the procurement officer, the doctor, the engineer, and other officers who are participating in the process. We also informed them that.
Dr. Charles Kajura, the focal person for development response to displacement impact project in Hoima, says since the inception of the project in 2018, the team has received 18 billion shillings that has been disbursed to 341 groups in the district, and over 8,000 people have so far benefited from the project.
Indeed affecting the poorest of the poor. For example, the 39% category which we want to serve. And if you go down, you will find that there are the people suffering, and depending on the environment, actually, they survive on the environment. So really, this is a very sensitive area. And the district, through Dr. Deep, we have over 8,000 direct beneficiaries within Sanlam and livelihood. And all these were the people who are being targeted in the communities who are the poorest of the poor.
When it comes to livelihood program, we still have people who are working now. We have triggered household income and people are working.
Story by Godfrey Muhumza for the news.